Hello friends, my name is Samir and I'm today going to talk about delegation. You have heard many times that you are not able to complete your responsibility and take more work before you are not able to delegate well. Some major delegate you the task and say that it will help to get promotions. You must be thinking that what is delegation and how I can achieve this. Delegation is to assign the task with the authority to the subordinate, but still you are responsible to complete this activity. Some examples are, you are going to pay the service, you are responsible for lunch preparation, you are responsible for contact agreement or document preparation. Those all are the example of delegation. If in case you are not delegating, there is a high possibility that you are doing micromanagement. Micromanager delegate the task but give too much reporting inputs and do lot of reviews of the job in between, which usually staff doesn't like. When you try to delegate the activity, it depends on three things: your leadership style, importance of the task, your subordinate skills and the confidence level. You cannot delegate everything to everyone till the time you mature it completely. Let me explain you in detail. First is importance of the task. A task can be divided between important and urgent quadrant. Something which is important and urgent, you cannot delegate it completely as you want to hold control around this. You are responsible to report it timely. Something which is urgent but not important may be delegated. You just require a regular reporting for assurance that it will be completed. So you can still give this to your best resource. Important. You may be able to delegate but love a regular reporting. And finally, not important, not urgent. It's the best item to delegate because it's not generating any value for you. Now if I go to the second topic, which is a leadership style. If you are the person who want to get hold of everything, it will be difficult to delegate because you want to know each and everything. If you are a person who are managed by micromanager or task is in an urgent list, you will not able to delegate it again because you are the micromanager. And your micromanager always asks you for the report anytime. Now if I go to the third one, which is subordinate level and trust on him, a subordinate with the right level of skill and confidence can get a free hand and he already proved himself, so he can provide it the delegation. If a subordinate is new but an experience, he may get instruction early, but slowly gradually it can move to the delegated authority. If a subordinate is new and not skilled, you can't delegate it right now. He is not prepared for delegation. Now, you will have a question. How you can increase the delegation when you say that it is important to grow? You have to assess the importance of the task on this important urgency quadrant. You have to assess the level of your subordinate and start with some supervision to a delegation in a free hand. You have to move focus from urgent to important quadrant because urgent is difficult to delegate, but important may be delegated to the right functionality. Friends, delegation is one of the important skills to grow, and I will recommend you to gradually move from micromanagement to delegation because no one loves micromanagement and it's a challenge if you stay there on micromanagement for a longer time. That doesn't mean that micromanagement is bad. There are situations where you need a micromanagement. Please give a comment on this video. Do let me know if you want to hear about any specific topic. Do like and subscribe if you love this video. You can also visit SSLLC.com for registration about the course on life skill training. Thank you very much.